Assalamu alaikum dear students, hope all of you are fine by the grace of Almighty Allah. Welcome to NIEVS Homeschool. I am Naima Akhtar Tisha, Assistant Teacher Science, Morning Shift of National Ideal English Version School. Today I am going to take class 6 science class based on chapter 1 and is the chapter 1 lecture part 2. Let's start our class. Here is this chapter is under half yearly syllabus and our topic is chapter 1. In your previous class we have finished a part of chapter 1. Today we will finish this chapter and do the exercise. It is our lecture number 2 and here I have given some information. If you face any problem you can communicate with me. Let's see. The chapter name is Scientific Process and Measurement. We feel the necessity of valid measurement in every sphere of our life. It is essential to measure accurately. Generally, while measuring something, a certain fraction of the measurable article is considered as standard. That means when you want to measure the length of any substance, at first you have to consider any thing as standard, any length as standard. In each case of measurement, the result is expressed by a unit. There are various systems of unit for measurement. Normally we use SI system, MKS system, CGS system for measurement. Different countries would use different units to measure the same quantity. Considering the problems caused by this difference in unit for measurement, one common system of unit was introduced for all the countries of the world in 1960. That means in 1960, worldwide same type of measurement system has been established, and if you considered any length as 1 meter, then worldwide it will be considered as 1 meter. This is known as SI or International System of Unit. It is the abbreviation of SI unit, SI or International System of Unit. In case of SI unit or International System of Unit, in your book 7 units are given. They are in your book page number 6. Here they are length is meter, unit of length is meter, unit of mass is kilogram, unit of time is second, unit of temperature is Kelvin, unit of electric current is ampere, and the unit of luminous intensity is candle, and the last one, the unit of amount of substance is mole. These 7 units are considered as the fundamental unit. Now, this, what is fundamental unit and what is derived unit? The main core unit is fundamental unit, that means single unit. Some of the quantities can be measured and expressed by single unit. This unit is known as fundamental unit. Unit of mass, time, temperature, electric current, luminous intensity and the amount of substance are fundamental unit. And what is derived unit? Some of the quantities cannot be measured and expressed by a single unit. For measuring this, we need combination of 2 or more units, or combination of 2 or more units are required. That for measuring this, here it will not occur. For measuring this, combination of 2 or more units are required. These combined units are known as complex and derived unit. Now let's see some point. At first, SI unit or International System of Unit, SI unit or MKS unit. This MK is, M is the unit of length. M indicate this M. We use here small m. Okay, M K S, unit of length is meter, unit of mass is kilogram. K indicate kilogram, and unit of time will be second. From the name SI unit or MKS unit, we can understand unit of length is meter, unit of mass is kilogram, and unit of time is second. Then another unit, it is CGS unit. From this we can understand unit of length is centimeter, unit of mass is gram, and unit of time is second. So from the name CGS unit, there are mainly two different kinds of unit which is followed worldwide. SI system, it is the main system, and another is CGS system. In SI system, I have shown you already, and now it is CGS system, and these are the unit in CGS system. Now, fundamental unit and derived unit. Fundamental unit. Now, fundamental unit. Here I have already said sum of the quantities can be measured and expressed by single unit. This unit is known as fundamental unit. That means in case of such kind of measurement unit, we can use only one unit for expressing anything. If we consider the length of anything, we can easily express it by suppose the length of this stick is 5 meter. Suppose then 5 meter, this meter, by using this meter I can easily indicate the unit of length. No more unit is required for expressing that. And also the breadth, if we consider the breadth of this length of this pen is 3 meter, and the breadth of this is 2 meter, then look, I can easily express it by one fundamental unit or one unit. But if I want to calculate the area of this pen, the pen which is in my hand, area, then I have to multiply the length with breadth. The length with breadth, that means 3 into 2, 3 meter, here will be 3 meter and 2 meter. Look here, 3 meter and 2 meter, and the result will be 6 meter square. This meter and this meter turns to meter square. That means what? Here is 2 meter. In expressing the unit of area, we need 2 meter. But in expressing the length, unit of length, we need only 1 meter. And so area is derived, unit of area is derived unit, and unit of breadth and length is fundamental unit. Again, there is another example. If we consider, want to calculate the volume, then we need height. height. If I consider the height is 1 meter, then look here, volume, area into height. Area into height. Then 6 meter square into 1 meter. And the result will be 6 meter cube. Here it is cube. Meter cube. That means we need 3 meter to express the unit of volume. But we need one unit to express the, fundamental unit to express the unit of length. But we need 2 or 3 unit to express the unit of area and volume. So area and volume both are derived unit. But length and breadth are fundamental unit. So I think you have understood what is fundamental unit and what is derived unit. Now the exercise, let's start the exercise. Our first it is fill in the blanks. There are 2 types of unit of measurements. What are they? Fundamental units and derived units. What are the fundamental units? Okay, I am writing here, fill in the blanks. First one, fundamental units. Fundamental and derived. Number two is, as per international system, the number of fundamental SI units, I already have told you there are 7 SI units. 7. And what are they? I already have told you in your book, page 6, you can find there. Okay, then then 3, in all systems of measurement, the unit of time is what? Unit of time is in CGS and in SI system, we already have seen that the unit of time is second. Unit of time is second. Now, the multiple choice question. Multiple choice question number 1. Let's see here, which one is the unit of mass in SI system? Which one was unit of mass? I have already told you, kilometer, kilogram, Kelvin or candela. It is kilogram. Number B, kilogram. Kilogram. 2, the space obtained by a brick is called, look here, there is a picture of brick. If we consider any brick, it as it is a solid substance, it contains height, length and breadth. So the space occupied by a brick is area, volume, mass or length. It will be volume. Number B, volume. Area occupied by or space occupied by a brick. Brick is a solid substance, so it will be volume. Now here is a stem. Let's see, it's a solid substance, and here in a jar, in liquid, a solid substance is hanging. Look here, at first this layer, I am indicating this one. Look here, in this layer, it is 10 cc. It is height before dropping the stone. Here a stone is dropped in the water. 10 cc is the height before dropping the stone. And 15 cc is the height of liquid. Height after dropping the stone. That means in normal condition the liquid height was 10 cc, but when you drop any this stone in the water, its length or its height increase and it goes up to 15 cc. Okay, now first question, what is the volume of the stone in the figure? Look here, from after dropping the stone, the water height increase from 10 up to 15. So if we subtract 10 from 15, then we will get the stone volume. If we subtract 10 from 15, then we will get 5 cc, and this 5 cc is the volume of stone. So number will be A, 5 cc. Then the last question, to determine the volume of the substance in figure A, multiplication of how many units is required? I have shown you already that in case of solid substance we required, or in case of calculating volume we required 3 units. What are they? Length units, breadth units and height units. So the answer will be 3. That means answer will be C. Number 4, answer will be C, 3. Dear students, I hope you have understood today's topic. Please keep practicing at home and stay safe. Thank you.